All right, I'm going to be running through some of the boring stuff that you guys need to know, because there's been a bunch of changes that people need to know before they run out. So I'm going to quickly run through the overview of the conference and hopefully help you understand what's happening where, what are some of the important bits that you need to know. So let me get my slides up. Has everyone got the Wi-Fi username password? No? All right. So that's the kind of boring stuff I'm going to do. All right. So that's the Wi-Fi username password right up there. If you've not made a note of it, you can. By the way, my name is Naresh. I'm the guy who's been spamming you with emails. That's how people keep knowing me. I'm one of the organizers of this conference. Last year, I think, when we did the Selenium conference, Dan was here, when we did the Selenium conference, and I think he said, "What if we rename Selenium conference to Appium conference, because you know it's big enough?" And you know that kind of got a couple of us thinking. Sai and I want to call out to you guys. Sai and Srini, if you guys can quickly stand up. I mean, we're having the Appium conference, I would say, because these two guys really pushed hard. So certainly appreciate that. I know you guys have been sitting a while, so how about doing a quick stand-up exercise? Yeah?
I like it.
All right, can we please stand up? It'll keep the energy high. It's actually amazing to see a full hall, so it's good. Thank you all for coming in. What we want to do is a little exercise where we self-organize ourselves into groups of 10. And you know, the 10 people in your group have to basically fulfill one of these roles that is up on the screen. That's it. Self-organize. And form a group of 10 people. We'll see who wins, whichever group comes first. Thank you, sir.
Yeah.
Do we have a winner? I see one group over there. One more group over there. That's cool. All right, I see 6 groups so far. That's pretty cool. All right, thank you guys. That was good. 6 groups pretty quickly. All right, please sit down. That's it. Any ideas why we do this? A, to highlight the diversity of people we have here in terms of different roles, different people from different places. 352 participants in the room from 198 different companies here. So it's pretty diverse group in terms of from where people are coming. But more importantly, in my opinion, people come to conference to network with other people, to kind of see what other people are doing, not just the speakers, but there's a wealth of knowledge that you know folks like you bring to this conference. And this was just a little exercise to get you to kind of interact with other people, and hopefully over the next 2 days, you're going to use the opportunity to meet other people from different companies, see what is going on in their company, and hopefully have a good networking experience. All right? Can I do one more quick stand-up exercise? Just please stand up wherever you are. Sit down if you have traveled for 10 kilometers radius from the hotel. If you stay within 10 kilometers radius. All right? How about 50 kilometers radius from the hotel? That should cover most of the Bangalore. How about 100 kilometers? 500? What about 1,000 kilometers radius? That should cover most of India. Wow, all right. 5,000 kilometers? Maybe, not sure. All right, so thank you guys for traveling for more than 5,000 kilometers to be here with us. So we actually have people from 25 different countries here, which is pretty amazing. I think for Selenium conference, we've had 20 countries, but Appium kind of beats that record. So that's cool. I would like to thank the speakers that we have here. We have 38 speakers today. The font is really bad, but I'm just going to read that out. So we have 38 speakers, again, from 14 different countries who are here to speak with us. So again, if you see the speakers, please do thank them. All of these speakers, you know, are kind of volunteering, coming out here to spread the knowledge that they have. So again, thanks for all the speakers who have come from far to help us here. Does anyone know how long it took for us to put this conference together, other than the program committee? 8 months? 8 months back, we announced the conference. It took us about 6 months of actually going through, putting the program together, working through the program committee. The way the conference is put together, I think few of you have participated in that. We have an open submission system where we invite for speakers to put in their proposals. Speakers submit their proposals. We have a program committee that reviews those proposals, try to give feedback, try to work with them to improve the proposals, and then we finally select a set of proposals. So if you were to look at how it basically panned out, we had 73 proposals that came in, and out of which we accepted 40, so about 50% selection. And a lot of this was to try and work closely with the speakers to try and improve the proposals that came in. So again, if you did not get an opportunity this year to submit your proposal, we will be doing the conference again, hopefully next to next year, alternative years. And we would encourage you to submit the proposals to participate in the conference. It's open to everybody to come and speak at the conference. The graph down there basically tries to show you how we've tried to balance the different kinds of talks at the conference. So when we do selection, we also try and look at a healthy mix of different types of sessions, talks, workshops, demonstrations, and so forth. So we try and balance that out. After this session, we're going to be breaking for a coffee break when they're going to be dividing the halls and we're going to be splitting into three parallel tracks, right? So those are the three parallel tracks that you see. This is going to be track number one, Grand Ballroom one. This is going to be track number one. The dividers are going to come in there once you guys step out, and then that's going to be ballroom number two. So track two is going to be over there. And track three, you go out of the hall and take a left turn, and all the way in the corner, that direction, there's a room called Jupiter. So that's going to be track number three. Clear? Three tracks, simple, all on the same floor, which is going to be here. It's actually not true that we only have three tracks. We actually have four tracks. Where's the fourth track? The hallway track, which in my opinion is the most interesting track. Not saying that the speakers are boring, but I think it's fun to hang out and meet people, and a lot of interesting conversations happening outside. So there is a fourth track happening there. Can everyone just basically check their delegate kits if they've got the feedback form? Got it? No? Sorry, we don't do feedback forms. Why don't we do feedback forms? Save paper? That's a good reason. But I find this form of giving feedback the most useless form of giving feedback. Not about going digital, it's about actually getting feedback in the spirit of getting feedback, right? If you put in the feedback in this form, send it out to us, when will we act upon it? At the earliest, next conference. Right? Is that going to be helpful? To wait for the next conference before we can act on the feedback? I don't think that's a very useful or, you know, better way of giving feedback. What we generally encourage is that, you know, kind of come in. I'm going to highlight who are the volunteers in the program committee, and it would be actually helpful if you can give us feedback now so we can actually try and fix things as we go along during the conference, right? Instead of trying to wait for another year. Also, sometimes there is some thought process and context behind why certain things is in a certain way. And it might help if you come and talk to us. We may be able to help you explain the context of why some things was done some way. And then that may help you appreciate, you know, what happened. For example, one common complaint will be, why do we have so many plastic bottles? Right? And fair enough, we do also have water dispensers, so you can, and there are glasses, so you can use those. If you don't want to use the plastic bottle, there are options like that. But why do we do this? Because there are a lot of people who, A, feel uncomfortable drinking from dispensers, so we don't want to be like, you know, screw you, drink water from here only, right? Also, there's a liability that the hotel has if someone falls sick, and so they want to make sure that they're covered, right? So there are things like that that hopefully when you explain to someone, they may appreciate why certain things are done certain way, right? So all I'm trying to say is if there's something that, you know, bothers you that you think is worth highlighting, if you can come to talk to one of us, it'll be really helpful because A, we will learn something, or there's a small possibility that you may learn something. All right? Are you with me? There's also another important thing with putting this up. This is a 100% volunteer-run nonprofit conference, right? All of us have regular daytime jobs just like you, and we are here, you know, as a community trying to put this together. So if you see small things that can be improved, don't wait for someone to fix it. Right? Take charge. This is your conference. Right? Which is, again, when you put these feedback forms, it's kind of like somebody else's problem. No, it's our problem, right? We want to improve this experience for ourselves. So are you with me? Awesome. How many people are familiar with the law of 2 feet? Few people who've been to open space conferences, it comes from there. So the law of 2 feet is one of the things that I think is very important for our conference, and I really want to spend like 2 minutes talking about it. What it basically talks about is if you find yourself in a session where you're not adding value or getting value, what do you do? Look for feedback form, but that ain't there. What do you do in those cases? Take your 2 feet, right? And take yourself to a place where you will get value or add value. Of course, it's impolite to kind of get up and disturb everyone when you leave, right? So we request everyone to kind of silently leave. When you're coming in the door, make sure the doors are closed just so it doesn't disturb other people. So just basic courtesy, but it's completely acceptable and encouraged for you to basically move out of a session if you're not getting value from the session, right? There are at least 3 options, and then there is the 4th option outside, right? So hopefully in one of those 4 places, you will surely get value, right? So how many people will use the law of 2 feet? That's awesome. How many people know about the story of how Appium almost got killed by Jason? Not many people. That's good. Few people. All right, so this evening we're going to have lightning talks, which is kind of how Dan introduced APM before it was called APM at Selenium Conf 2014? 2012, sorry. So in spirit of that, we actually have like a keynote talk where everyone's going to be in this room and we're going to do lightning talks at 5:30, all right? How it's going to work is basically there is no pre-signing or any of that stuff. We're going to have a board here. People walk up, write their name and just queue up, and then it's going to be 5 minutes or 3 minutes. We will take that call depending on how many people show up for giving the talks, but you know, that's the plan. Dan is going to facilitate that. So we're going to have 5:30 lightning talk. So if you want to present something to everybody here, think about a topic that you have in mind, and you know, be ready for lightning talks at 5:30 this evening. There is a prize for what? For the best? The crowd determines the most popular lightning talk, and Dan has a personal gift for them. Maybe date with Dan. It's not that. Okay, he's just being clear. All right. I do want to really thank our wonderful sponsors, without whom it would not be possible to put this conference together. So it's not just about financially supporting us, but also giving us the confidence, helping us reach out to people, and various other forms of helping us to basically make this conference viable. The sponsors are outside, so please do stop by and meet them. But please do give them a big round of applause for helping us put this conference together. They're just outside, as you can see. It's hard to miss them, so please do stop by and see. They have some very interesting things going on. So, for example, one of the sponsors is giving away some exciting prizes if you participate in a contest they're running. Essentially, you need to share your Appium tip either on Twitter or LinkedIn on using that hashtag, and then tomorrow evening we're going to give away these prizes. Has everyone got the app on themselves? Don't test it out. There are no tests for the Appium. There are no Appium tests or any kinds of automated tests for this app, but it works mostly. So please do get this app. Why do you need to get this app? So A, it's going to help you kind of see what's coming up and things like that. So it's just easier to kind of manage that. You can add things to your calendar. You can basically look at the schedule. You can see who else is attending by basically clicking that and kind of get all the details of the session. There may be chances that, you know, some speaker may not be able to come, or we swap some sessions and things like that. So this remains up to date. If you have printed stuff, that will go out of date and things like that. But this is one cool way to kind of just keep up to date with what's going on. So encourage everyone to basically download the app. There's also a poster outside where you can get this thing, but it's just a conference app. You can, you know, another feature in the app which, you know, you may be interested is there's an option to win some pretty cool prizes that the sponsors are giving away by going into the app and claiming those goodies and then going and seeing the sponsors. For example, you may be walking away with this quadcopter today, right? So, but we also want to be inclusive. There may be someone who says, like, I don't want your shitty app. That's perfectly fine. You can go, there is a web version of it where you can look at the schedule on the web. This is how it'll look. You can basically, that's the URL, it's also there here, sked.link/appium. You would be able to rate the sessions here as well. So, sorry, I kind of missed that back here. But once you go to this thing here, you'd be able to, once the session is over, that plus mark is going to turn into a star, so you'd be able to click and rate the sessions. And it's important for us to get the rating so we know which speakers are, you know, being well received, which speakers are not. So it would greatly help planning the next year's conference if you rate the session. So please do rate the session either through the app or through the web version. Both allows you to rate the sessions. All right? With me? Just wanted to put the Wi-Fi username and password again here in case someone wants it. Just want to request the program team to please stand up. All right, so if you're not happy with the program, So again, thanks a lot for the wonderful work you guys have done. Greatly appreciate that. And we do have volunteers, so can I have the volunteers quickly stand up? So Pooja is there, Anand, Vishal, Rahul, Vishal there. So we're going to be in different rooms, so you know, if you need any help, reach out to one of us. We don't have any special t-shirts or things, we're cost-cutting, but you'll find us. All right, with that, I will shut up, and thank you again. We will see you again in 20 minutes, I guess. We're going to split the halls, and we're going to kickstart the sessions. We do try and start the sessions on time and end the sessions on time, so request your help to keep that kind of momentum, all right? Thank you. See you in the evening.